Hello, this is Michael Sulock, and in this video we are going to be finding the exponential equation through the points 1,6 and 3,54. We're going to be doing this procedure using algebra. I have another video where I show you how to do this if you have a Texas Instruments graphing calculator. But in this video, that won't be necessary. So let's get started. We have these two points here. We are going to figure out the equation of this blue line, this curve, that goes through those particular points. This curve is going to have the format of f of x equals a times b to the x power, where a always happens to be the y-intercept. That's true for exponential equations, any of them. And b is something that you might see called the growth factor, where b is always positive. It has to be bigger than zero. So we expect for this problem our b value to be something bigger than 1. It's definitely worth noting at this point that of our two points here, neither one is the y-intercept. And that's going to make this slightly harder, because if you are given the y-intercept, then you are given the value of a. For this particular problem, we're going to have to find both a and b. We're going to find b first, and once we know what b is, we're going to figure out what a is. So our first step is to use the points that we're given to write two equations. Both of those equations are going to be based off this format, f of x equals a b to the x. And because f of x and y are the same thing, so if we take this first point, which means that, and then using my other point, so now we have two equations. And my next step is going to be pick one of these, and I'm going to solve it for a. I'm going to get a by itself. And because this one has smaller numbers, I'm just going to choose to use this one. I'm going to leave this exponent as a 1 here. I think it'll make it a little more clear what happens later on down the line. Solving this for a is really just one step, and I've done step 2. I've solved this equation for a. Now I'm ready for my third step, which is to substitute into the other equation. The other equation in this case is the other of the two that I made in step 1. And so earlier I found out that, and here's a right here. The a in these two equations has the same value. I don't know it yet, but it's the same. So I'm going to take this equation, and instead of writing a, I'm going to substitute 6 over b to the first. I want to solve this for b, and I want a little more room to do that, So I could take this right side, but I could write it as one big fraction, and I could rewrite that as like this. And if you think about exponents and what this means algebraically, what happens is that these two are going to cancel each other out. You just end up with two b's by itself, b squared. And so there's a rule for this for algebra, which could be negative if n is greater than m, which means that you end up with b's on the bottom of this fraction instead of on the top like we have here. This piece over here is going to turn into b squared, and so now I have to solve for b. I'll have to deal with this exponent eventually, but right now I'm going to divide by 6. So coming up here, I have 9 equals b squared. And so I have to do the inverse operation of squaring, which is taking the square root. The square root is the same thing as b to the 1/2 power. And if you were solving 9 equals b squared, not in the context of exponential equations, you would need a plus and minus over here. But because we're dealing with an exponential function where our b is always positive, the negative answer is not going to appear here. It's not going to be possible. So when we're at this step, we need to take the square root of both sides. And what I was talking about earlier, I could also write, what happens on the right side is that these exponents are going to cancel out. They're going to go away. And I encourage you, if you get a situation like this and you need to take a root of both sides, if you write it out like this, it will be easier to find the computations necessary. And it's not that bad for this problem. We know that the square root of 9 is 3. B is the number 3. If this had been to the fifth power, we would have needed taken the fifth root of both sides, which would have been equivalent to doing both sides to the 1 over 5 power. So step 4, we are going to take our exponential equation format and we're going to substitute either point that we were given. It doesn't matter, you can choose. I'm going to pick this first point because it has the smaller numbers. So now I just need to solve for a, and I get a equals 2. Because these canceled and 6 divided by 3 was just 2. That concludes the math I needed to do to finish this problem. I could include a fifth step, which is my answer. F of x is my function, and that's going to be 2, that was my a, times 3. And x is just a variable in this equation, it can change. And this is my exponential equation. It goes through the y-axis at a height of 2. It has a growth factor of 3, which means it grows quite rapidly. And that was finding an exponential function through these two given points. I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to leave me a comment. This is Michael Sulock, and I will see you next time.